The much-awaited economic survey has finally been tabled in the Lok Sabha to present the status of the economy. In the last year, the economic survey presented by Nirmala Sitharaman, this comes right ahead of the Budget 3.0 tomorrow. Nirmala tables the economic survey in the Lok Sabha. A lot of expectations, undoubtedly, on the economic survey. In fact, Indian economy has grown certainly at a fast pace. The years right after COVID may have registered fast growth rate, but we've seen several ups and downs to which Nirmala Sitharaman will be presenting the bygone year and the status, the way the country has handled the economic situation and how they will be tackling the status and issues within the economy with the budget that will be presented tomorrow. So the year that's gone by, the economic survey that's been conducted, presented by Nirmala Sitharaman, she's tabled it in the Lok Sabha. Big update coming in on the economic survey that's been tabled. This comes right ahead of the big budget 3.0. The seventh time, remember, Nirmala Sitharaman is presenting the budget. And right before the budget, as per convention, she is presenting the economic survey. In fact, many outside economists have argued that India's potential growth has fallen from 8% to 6%. These are issues that will be highlighted, hopefully, in this economic survey that's been tabled by Nirmala Sitharaman. We're going to cut to those live images that's coming in. In the Lok Sabha, Sitharaman has presented the economic survey right ahead of the big budget tomorrow. Budget session that will begin tomorrow. Trust India Today to bring you all the live updates. It's going to be a common man's budget. Of course, the economy and its growth is going to be extensively spoken on. Today, we'll have a certain picture on what the year that's gone by really looks like. Let's listen in.
Sir, with your permission, I rise to lay on the table a copy of each of the following papers, both in Hindi and English versions. Economic Survey 23-24, Economic Survey 23-24 Statistical Appendix. Sir, with your permission, I rise to lay on the table a copy of each of the following papers, both in Hindi and English versions. Economic Survey 23-24, Economic Survey 23-24 Statistical Appendix.
All right, Nirmala Sitharaman is now going to be presenting that economic survey. It's going to be met with a lot of opposition. It's going to be a fiery session inside the parliament today. Nirmala Sitharaman, as she's all set to present the economic survey right amid a time when you have several critics claiming that India's growth has fallen from 8% to 6% in the last year. In fact, the IMF in July this year revised India's growth forecast from 6.8% to 7%, an increase due to the improvement in private consumption, especially in rural India. But yet we see critics and economists outside India claiming that India's economy, that way the potential growth has fallen in the last year. Let me quickly cut across to Shailendra Bhatnagar, chief analyst and editor, Business Today. Mr. Bhatnagar, please take it away. What exactly do we expect from this economic survey? A lot that is likely to be discussed on the Indian economy in the last 1 year. And this comes right ahead of the budget session tomorrow. What are going to be the indicators?
For having me over. I think the economy per se is in fine shape. Of course, there are pain points which are there everywhere. But if you look at the performance of how the government-led capex in roads, ports, railways and airports has happened over the last two and a half years. They've given a very, very strong kicker to growth as far as the government side of the business is concerned. But what is critical to look at is that private consumption is low. Large parts of rural India are yet to see the pre-COVID kind of investment and income levels. And of course, you have this global crisis in Europe as well as in other parts, which is impacting India's imports. All put together, you see an uptick in the economy, but the government has its hands full. It needs to sort of battle rural stress. it needs to somehow kickstart private capex, and it needs to do something on private consumption. All these three things are missing from what is actually a wonderful equation as far as markets are concerned, as far as the broader economy is concerned. So far, only aspirational India is spending. The consumption in rural, in smaller income groups, in smaller towns and cities actually hasn't picked up issues that the government is facing. So all these things need to be settled within tomorrow, and let's see how it pans out.
Right. Shailendra, of course, we're looking at record high unemployment rates. We're looking at sharp poverty, inequality in wealth. This is also something that we expect the budget to address. Do you feel the economic survey today will also highlight that?
Absolutely. I think jobless growth, although we are growing at 6.57%, which is one of the finest growth rates in major economies globally, but it's an absolute pinch when you look at the kind of problems that are being seen as far as job creation is concerned. A lot of states have actually acted upon by giving it out handouts to either jobless youth or to old pensioners in terms of expanding the medical scheme. But yes, I agree completely. This is something that needs to be addressed urgently until it becomes a major problem. And I'm sure the budget will outline a lot of things. The positives on this end is a lot of fiscal room, comfortable tax revenues, and of course, a lot of growth coming in from at least the government capex side. So money is there. How it is spent on these three troubling points remains to be seen, and it will be all clear by 12 noon tomorrow.
Thanks very much, Shailendra, for joining us on that.